four brilliant nominees, and now we'll ask Mel and Deary to announce the recipient.
Ladies and gentlemen, it's my great, great pleasure to announce the winner, Mervyn Eades.
Before Mr. Eades goes, can I call on some colleagues to come forward as well? Can I call on Bryce Wilson and particularly the sponsors without whom this event could not have happened? Can I call on Van, please come forward? Brick Mitri from Mitri Lawyers, to please come forward? Thomas from Unions New South Wales, is Thomas here? Yes, please, Thomas. Yes. And also Jerry Georgiatos. Please come forward, Jerry. You're one of the sponsors. We'd like you to come.
Perfect. Okay. Beautiful. Thanks, guys. Okay. Can you just tip the front of the award down a bit? And a bit more. Put it down a bit more. That's it. Just so it doesn't bounce my flash back at me.
Yeah.
Perfect. Thanks, guys.
Well, great job. You've got to be more serious. Sorry. People don't understand. Otherwise.
That's the result.
Yeah. You can know.
Hi, my name's Mervyn Eades. I'd first like to acknowledge the land that I keep standing, the honour of the sovereign people of this country, the Ngunnawal people, traditional owners, past, present and future. I'd like to acknowledge that and thank them for that mustering of their country to be in to share this event on their land. I started Nullarmaya. Nullarmaya was a dream of mine to create opportunities. I come from a background of incarceration. I've been there, I've lived it, lived life experience. I've seen those dark, the dark side, the long corridors in those cells, locked up quarter of 7 at night. The island in NWA, we've got the highest incarceration rate of any Indigenous children in the world. My people, my Noongar people. And, you know, there was a gap in our community where nothing was being done to help our people break that cycle. And that's why I created Nullarmaya, to create opportunities, realistic opportunities for my brothers and sisters getting out of the system and help them change and break that cycle, because mainstream wasn't helping us break that cycle. And, you know, I wanted to create some realistic opportunities and give support, and from entry to exit, you know what I mean? The full support that our brothers and sisters need, encouragement, that, you know, the self-worth, the hopelessness that is entrenched within a lot of our people back home there, and a lot of our people across the nation, I think, because of colonisation and invasion and all that, we're still feeling the effects today. Human rights, it's always been a thing close to me, the human rights of my people, my Noongar people. And, you know, I always wanted to support my people in any way, forms, could. It's a great journey. I never before I've been in a prison cell 15 years ago and here standing today. You know, I've transformed my life and I let the brothers and sisters know that their lives can be changed too. But all they need is that support, that extra support and delivery of service by our people to our people. That's what sets us free, I think, and not enough of that has been done. By our people leading the way and transforming our people's lives. Because, you know, we care, because we love our people. We have that love and that mainstream don't seem to have for our people, but we have it for our people, and we like to see our people achieve the highest levels for all their dreams and that. We want to make them come true, and that's what I'm doing with the prison to work stuff in Perth there with Nala. We do the mentoring, or continuous mentoring from our point of entry to point of exit. Whilst they're training, they're getting their education, we do a mentoring, all the mentoring with them to keep them focused on what they've got to do and keep them there doing what they've got to do. But we always support them, we don't let go of them. When they go into the workforce, we do the same. We continue the mentoring until they tell us that they don't need us no more. And I think that's the way to fix a lot of our issues and serviceable delivery by our people to our people. I reckon that is the key. And I've said it all over Australia. The key to setting our people free is us. Us at the helm of our own destiny and our people in control of our own affairs. And, you know, self-determination and self-empowering our people through us as leading the way and giving them the opportunity to look up to other people who've been there. I've been to the lowest of the lows. You know, just the same as all my brothers. I'm no better than them, even today. I tell them like that they can come with me and they can reach the levels that I've reached. At the moment here in Western Australia, over home in Western Australia, we're fighting probably the greatest challenge that our people have ever had to put up on us. And that's the Indigenous Land Use Agreement. Our people have been asked to surrender and relinquish all our rights to native title for money. 200,000 square kilometres of land we've been asked to relinquish and surrender to cede our sovereignty and to go against all odds, to all the land rights fights that was fought for our people over in Western Australia. They're trying to do a deal with our land council and we said no, we're not going ahead with that. A group of us, Naomi Smith, Auntie Mimi McLean, Auntie Margaret Colbert and myself, we took the challenge to our land council and to the state. We took them to court, in the federal court. We won in the federal court before the full bench. And at the moment today here in Canberra, legislative changes to overrule the decision of our win. And that's what the legislation is all about and all the native title stuff at the moment. To overturn our decision. We're blackfellas. When we win, we don't win, sort of thing. You know, they can determine and make new laws to overturn the laws that we, you know, we went into the court system. That is their court system. We won in their court system. And they, because we win, they brought it back to Canberra here, Mr. Brandis and Glenn Kelly. He was our CEO of our Mervyn Land Council over in Perth. Glenn Kelly is a National Native Title Council CEO now. He's got promoted somehow, I don't know how. Probably done the job of all our people, I believe. And I'll say that to his face and to anyone. He's done a good job of our people. But extinguishing rights, Native Title, I don't think was designed for any of us to extinguish our rights to land. Over on our country, we've been asked to extinguish our rights, surrender. The words Colin Barnett came out and said, when they thought the deal was done, he came out and said, the Noongar people have now surrendered. There was no war, it was a massacre and a genocide, Mr. Barnett. We didn't go to war, just came in, invaded our country and declared war upon us. We were peaceful, we massacred our people. Now you're trying to take away our land. And to the Mabo family and that, the great Mabo family. I don't believe that native title was meant to do this, a total dispossession, dispossessing our people on our land, offering us economical base and sustainability for the rights of our land, and you know, asking us to surrender our rights for that economic sustainability. And if that's what they have to offer, we cannot sell or cede our sovereign rights to country. And what I would like to say to the Aboriginal ministers in this room, we don't have any Noongar people fighting for Noongar country at Canberra. We'd love for you to be our champions. And you are there to represent our people, represent all our people. Speak up and help us save our rights to country on Noongar land. We don't have no Noongars here in Parliament. We don't have no Noongars representing us. We do not wish to surrender and relinquish our rights to country. And I take my hat off to Melan Barry McCarthy from the Herd. When we came over here a few weeks ago and spoke to you, I knew you was the person that would take the challenge for us and I'll fight for our people. And, you know, it needs to be done. Ministers, when they get in this place representing Aboriginal people, they need to start representing Aboriginal people at the highest levels. Don't care if it doesn't go, if it goes against the grain of government. This is not our government. This is the invading government. And, you know, they've never told the truth in this country ever. They've never treated with our people. They've never, you know, in 1967 they allowed us to vote, but they still never recognised our people. We need our champions in government to fight for us and, you know, help our people not surrender our rights to land. Thank you.
Joe, you said that often you don't feel the love. I hope tonight in this room you do feel the love. Please, another round of applause for Mervyn Eades. We'll pause for you to enjoy your dinner and then be back very soon. Thank you.